Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here. Hope you are too. I wanted to share something with you today. I'm going to talk about sharing, and we're going to talk about sharing your hot dog business or your vending business and how to do it the right way so that you get the most bang for your buck. Okay. Except there's no bucks required. This is all free marketing. And it works better than paid marketing. Now, paid marketing, you can buy more marketing space, but this works better and has a higher ratio of people that follow you and want to be a part of it than paid marketing does. So I wanted to share this with you, and hopefully it helps your business out. A lot of vendors get started and they just don't know, how to get it out there. They'll oftentimes create a Facebook page and they're like, oh yeah, I'm on the ball now. I've got a Facebook page and I created a website and an Instagram and a Twitter and a Snapchat and a TikTok. I'm good to go. Right. But, the problem is people don't know you exist. And with over a billion users just on TikTok, you might have a little bit of a challenge, getting people on there. So what do you do? You don't need to advertise or market to the world, right? So I want to talk about some of the things you can do that will make life easier and get your name out there quicker than anything else that I know of on social media. So Facebook is a given. You have to have a Facebook page. Create yourself a business Facebook page, okay? Now, I'm going to show you a vendor in our Vendors United group. He's an awesome vendor. You've seen me vend with him live at events, at a Porsche event, and all kinds of stuff. Anyway, over on the YouTube page and on learnhotdogs.com. But I want to share with you today what he's doing and what others are doing that we've been teaching in the Vendors United group. But I figured, you know what, this is just one of those things that everybody should be doing. I want you to be successful. This will help you become successful quicker, especially when you're first starting out. Kathy, holy cow, I just saw this. I'm going to post this up here. Look at this right here. I'm watching you from a cruise ship. I am loyal. I'd say so. If I was on a cruise ship, I'd have me a trawling line off the back, trying to see what I could catch in international waters. Have fun on your trip, Kathy. That's exciting. So, all right. Here's what I want to share with you and tell you what to not tell you what to do, but you'd be wise to follow this advice. When a vendor posts up a video, let's say you create a Facebook page and you create a video and you're like, hey, we're going to be at so-and-so today. We're going to be out front all day long today, or from 12 to 2 today, or 11 to 1 today, or whatever it is. It's usually like 11 to 1 or 11 to 2, right? Well, the problem is how many people are going to see that, and how many people are going to see it in time? Because Facebook, you've been on your newsfeed. You got some great family and friends on your newsfeed you never see on your newsfeed. Well, why? Because there's little things that Facebook does, algorithms. Okay. I don't know what kind of German name that is, but, or word that is, but anyway, it basically means they have computers that are figuring out what you like by what you visit and what you talk about on Siri and Google and all those other little devices. Right. So they deliver you content that way. So even though your mom is your best friend in the world, you may never see her on Facebook because Facebook goes, we'd rather give you this stuff from these people than your mom's stuff. Now you can fix that by just going over to your mom's post, like a few stuff like that, or click the see it first button. And then you'll get more of it. Facebook will be like, he does love his mom. He does want to see some of her stuff. We'll show him a couple things. So that's the kind of stuff that hinders you when you're posting a marketing message. Okay. But I want to talk to you about the marketing message. I see some vendors that post up something, like this. I'm going to grab this here, and they're like, look, we have this beautiful hot dog. it is awesome. We're going to be serving all day. And they're just talking to the camera, which is great. It's good to have yourself on there every now and then. People like that. But for you shy people or for anybody else, even your non-shy people, people love video and photos of food. Okay. So you would take a picture of this. You'd have the camera pointing this way. You could still hear your voice, but you'd be going, oh, look at these today. I've got 79 of these today, or whatever you want to say, or you're not going to believe this. You are, if you get a drop of this sauce that we put on our sausages, our exclusive sausages or our exclusive hot dogs, if you put a drop of this on your forehead, your tongue will beat your brains out trying to get to it. And so that's more personal. That's more realistic. That's more, that's, and I'm not saying say those things, and you don't even have to be funny. You can go, you can completely be silent as long as you let them know some way or another that where you're going to be today or tomorrow or the next day. So you want to spread that message. Now, I haven't even gotten to the tip yet. Okay. I'm fixing to show you how good this works. So stay tuned. Right. So you'd want to put that out there and go, can you tell I've been doing electrical work? So you'd want to put that out there and go, okay, here's what I have. Well, the problem is you put that out there and then nobody sees it, or five people see it in your group because Facebook didn't deliver it to them yet. Facebook delivers it to them next Thursday, day late and a dollar short, right? But the problem is the dollar come out of your pocket. So you got to do it a different way. So I've tested this and I've played with it, and I've played with it in other industries, not just hot dog vending or street food vending or catering or drop-off catering or any of that stuff. I've played with it with my own family's businesses. Like I've got a dad who's got a sawmill. I've got a brother that's a chiropractor, right? So I've used these methods to help them get business immediately just by being realistic, just by being you. Instead of making some fancy freaking ad, you don't need to do that, right? So let me get to the point. Here's what all you have to do. Oh, look here. We got Paul Browning here today. Gregory Kay. All right. Let's see. Edward Hayden's in the house. Thank y'all for being here. Anyway, here's how I would do this exactly. And I'm going to pull up something real quick. This is my friend, Alex, and he's got Frankenstein's. Okay. Frankenstein's is his hot dog carton business, and you've seen the videos and all that stuff, right? But anyway, I want to show you his page, and I want to show you what he does to market. And it's something I tested for him without him even knowing. That's the cool thing. If you're able to do this and test it on somebody else. So I was able to test it without him even knowing. And he called me up and he's like, well, he actually WhatsApped me and he said, did you do that? And I said, yep. And he goes, holy cow. And so here's all I did. I'm going to show you how this works. Let me turn off my camera. I'm going to pull up Alex's. This is Alex's page. You can find him at Frankenstein's. There's the thing, at Frank and Stein's. Okay. So he's got a cool website and stuff. I've got to switch over here to the website. You should be seeing his posts and stuff, right? So I'm going to go over to his videos and I want to just show you something. Let's jump over here to page two, or let's go to page four. Okay. I want you to look. 106 views, 65 views, 71 views, 94 views, 63 views, 62 views. That's not bad. That's not bad. I mean, a really good vendor is Tickle Pink with 100 meals a day. I mean, that's a $700-$800 day for 2 hours of work, 3 hours of work. So that's a great goal to have. But what I'm going to say is, could you not increase this? Because not all 65 of the people that saw this video are going to come and get a hot dog and spend money. And they're also not going to see it the day you posted it. They might see it 2 weeks from now when Facebook goes, oh, we'll put this in there. Alex is going to be at the Habitat for Humanity in downtown Waynesville, North Carolina, at 2 p.m. For an event, right? And you're going, this was 2 weeks ago. That's how Facebook works. So here's what you can do to resolve that. I want you to show you something. We're going to go back over here to page one, and we're going to drop down. Look at these views, 72 views, 97 views. Here's one with 265. That's real good. 94. You seeing all these? I'm looking for a specific one, and you'll be able to tell which it is when I get to it. Dadgummit. I may have messed up when I switched the view. Oh, here it is. 811 views. And you're going, 811 views? How did he get 811 views? So I'm going to stop this real quick. This is just a normal video. Alex
hey,
is
Facebook.
Telling.
Hey, Waynesville, North Carolina. This is Alex of Frankenstein's. We are set up and ready to roll. It's Monday, Thanksgiving week. I know we won't be out Thanksgiving.
Now, do you see he's telling when and where he's going to be, right? But why did this one, why did this video get 811 views? And why did it get so many people immediately? And I'm fixing to show you why. Sharing, right? Now look here, four shares, and who's that at the top? Ben Wilson. Happens to be me. Here's what I did. All I did is I went and joined a group, one of these buy, sell, trade groups in his area, right? I just joined the group. And once I was in there, I posted up, oh my gosh, this guy's hot dogs rock. And then I shared that video. That's it. That's it. Literally, that's it. How I know this works for other industries is I told you I've done it for my brother that's a chiropractor. I've done it for my dad who has the sawmill thing. And my dad, you know, it's just luck of the draw. It's whoever drives by his sawmill is going to check it out, right? But that's it. He ain't advertising nowhere. He's got a Facebook page, but he ain't advertising nowhere. So I took a little video clip he had put on his Facebook page, which was like 37 seconds long, of some red, I think it's red oak, beautiful red oak going through the sawmill. And it was gorgeous wood. And I joined one of his local groups because he's in another state. I joined his group and then I shared that video and I said, oh my gosh, I'm going to get some of this wood and side my house with it. I didn't say where, when, how. Here's a tip. I want you to follow this. Here's a tip. Okay. Let me go back over to my screeny deeny thing here. So I did not, I'm going to pull this down real quick. Anyway, I didn't say, oh, you got to go to my dad's thing. Please buy some wood. I didn't even tell him who he was. I didn't even say what it was. I just shared that. Well, immediately, people started commenting. Where'd you get that? Where'd you find that? All these local people, because I joined one of his local yard sale, trade, buy, sell, swap groups on Facebook. Right. So when I shared that, people went berserk. He got, I think it was three jobs that day off of that video. One was a huge job, like, you know, 1600 board feet of wood or something. All because I shared a 32 second video. Now, and Alex, I tell you, he had one of the best days there at that location because I shared that one video. So how do you do that? It doesn't work as well if you share it, okay? Because then it doesn't have the same meaning, if you get my meaning, right? It doesn't mean the same when you're like, hey, look at these guys' tires that it sells. Ben Wilson Tire Store. And you go over there and it's Ben Wilson who posted it. That doesn't mean the same. But I do the video on my page, Ben Wilson Tires, right? And then I have somebody, a friend maybe, okay? And he takes and posts that in a local group. That could be anybody doing that for you. And what you will find is you will be busier every single freaking time you go out because it's organic. It feels better. People like sharing it better because it's not an ad. It's oh my gosh, did you see he zoomed in on the catch up? And you're like, oh my gosh, I got to have one of those today. And so you don't get all the people, but you don't need all the people. That's the beauty of this business is you don't need everybody. People call me up, Ben, I'm worried. There's two other vendors. I know one of them's in the VU group, and I don't know if there's enough business here for us. And I say to them, hey, how many gas stations you got in your town? I don't know. There's probably 500. And you're worried about one vendor? So those gas stations ain't closing up, right? So you'll probably be okay. Anyway, that's the way to market yourself and your stuff. Now, I want to explain something. It's not as simple as you going, like Alex, it wouldn't be wise of Alex to share his own post to a group. He could do that every now and then, okay, and say, hey, I'm Alex with Frankenstein's. Wanted to show you this new menu we just created or this new sauerkraut nobody has, whatever, right? Or we started selling alligator sausages. Come on down and get you one. Get a free possum slider on the side. He could do that. That works. That's genuine. But if you're going to be doing this regularly, you want somebody outside your circle, okay, that's known as your circle, to post that in there and go, hey, you wouldn't believe this pretty cedar wood I just got. It's gorgeous. Look, I think I'm going to do the deck on my new trailer and not say any more. And then watch the comments. Where'd you get that? Where did you get that alligator hot dog or that crocodile hot dog or that ostrich dog like Jason Brown sells? You know, where'd you get that? Oh, that's Jason Brown, Love Food Truck. They're over there at Skip Back right in front of the Dollar General. And you go, oh, and all of a sudden it starts coming together and all of a sudden you start making more money. You become more popular and people like that. People like to be in the know and they like to feel like they're not being advertised to, marketed to. We're marketed to constantly. So you putting a post up and spending that $20 on that Facebook button that says, promote your post. You've had more visitors to this post than ever before. You've had a total of 5. Please share it for $20 because Facebook's going to go broke if you don't. I'm being facetious, but don't spend that money there. There's other ways to spend that money. Don't spend it there. Okay. So you can do this and get way more people. You saw it. I just showed you on Alex's. Look at the view count right here. Let me see if I can blow that up closer. Look at that, 811, 4 shares. My shares caused other shares. My shares enticed other people to share. So people in the group, this local buy, sell, trade group in his town, shared it to other groups in the town because it was cool. It was, holy cow, I didn't know we had a hot dog vendor down there. He's going to be in O'Reilly's today. I am going to go get me a freaking hot dog. And so that's how simple that marketing can be for you. And that's how you do it. That's the way to do marketing. If you're going to do social media marketing, be real, be genuine, and also show close-ups of the food. Zoom in on the food. Make sure you're not taking crappy pictures. Okay. You can still post up pictures and stuff and share that. They're not as effective, but it still works. You want to do like a variety of things, but this right here works all day, every day, period, 8 days a week. All right. So I love you. I hope that helps. I'm glad you came and we're here. I'm on a fixing to go. I think I'm fixing to go grill something in the cold. So I'll talk to you soon.